Come in.
Ah, Ensign, what have you found?
I don't see any connection between this nebula and the one the Excelsior saw 80 years ago. This one's a class 17, while theirs was an 11. Both contain trace amounts of ceruleum, but that's about all.
But they do look similar.
To the naked eye, but not to sensors. Technically, they're very different. You know, I've been talking to the doctor, and he tells me it's not unusual for a repressed memory to resurface because of a smell or a visual detail. Maybe the visual similarities between the two nebulas simply triggered Tuvok's memory of the Excelsior.
But what about the memory of the little girl? What does she have to do with Tuvok's experiences on board Sulu's ship? The Excelsior seems so far removed from that childhood incident.
Who knows what goes on in a Vulcan's mind? Maybe there is no connection. And going back to the memory of the Excelsior was just an accident. A stray thought Tuvok was having because of the similarities between the two nebulas.
You may be right. Nevertheless, I've been studying the Excelsior logs.
What do they say?
Unfortunately, they don't say anything at all.
Nothing.
It would seem that Captain Sulu decided not to enter that journey into his official log. Today's entry makes some cryptic remark about the ship being damaged in a gaseous anomaly and needing repairs, but nothing else.
You mean he falsified his logs?
It was a very different time, Mr. Kim. Captain Sulu, Captain Kirk, Dr. McCoy. They all belong to a different breed of Starfleet officer. Imagine the era they lived in. The Alpha Quadrant still largely unexplored. Humanity on verge of war with Klingons, Romulans hiding behind every nebula. Even the technology we take for granted was still in its early stages. No plasma weapons, no multiphasic shields. Their ships were half as fast.
No replicators, no holodecks. You know, ever since I took Starfleet history at the Academy, I always wondered what it would be like to live in those days.
Space must have seemed a whole lot bigger back then. It's not surprising they had to bend the rules a little. They were a little slower to invoke the Prime Directive, and a little quicker to pull their phasers. Of course, the whole bunch of them would be booted out of Starfleet today. But I have to admit, I would have loved to ride shotgun at least once with a group of officers like that.
Sick bay to Captain Janeway.
Go ahead, Doctor.
I'm ready to revive Mr. Tuvok.
Acknowledged. I'm on my way.